Right. Hello, my name is Karen. I'm one of the talent agents here at Aquent who specializes in design and development. And I would love to introduce one of my lovely candidates, Frankie Monfort, who I had the pleasure of helping find a job for recently. Frankie, would you like to take a second to just introduce yourself?
Yes. Hi, guys. My name is Frankie. I'm a senior graphic designer. I've been working in the space for 10 years in many different design disciplines, agencies, small business organizations. Yeah,
awesome. We thought it'd be a great interesting sort of conversation to have, to share how our journey evolved together while we were working together to help Frankie find a new role. And you know, what happened with Frankie is actually a pretty common occurrence that does happen with a lot of designers that I do work with. So it's not always a straightforward road, you know, send through an application, get a job. Our job as a talent agent and as a good talent agent is to really see the potential in our candidates and to really work with them to draw out that potential if it's not so much being shown as well as it potentially could be. So in Frankie's case, this is one of those really great stories. So I guess to start off, Frankie, would you like to sort of tell everyone what happened when you applied for your role with me?
Yes. So I was looking for a new job, a new role in design. I know that I am a great graphic designer. So it was really perplexing when I was rejected from many different roles. When I looked at my folio, I was thinking, like, what's wrong with it? And I had an online presence, so I used Behance to showcase my work, and I applied for a role with Karen, and she helped and guided and shaped how I could actually present my portfolio better after many different instances where I was rejected from a lot of places. Really disheartening, and I had no knowledge or explanation as to why I was being rejected. They were just like, companies would just come back and say, yeah, sorry, you know, we've had to kind of move forward with your your application. And I just wasn't sure as to the reason why. It was really disheartening, and rejection after rejection. And then Karen was like my shining light, and she really helped and guided me through the process of finding a role, a fantastic role.
Yeah, well, I feel really lucky that we were able to connect, because when Frankie didn't actually get the role that he applied for, and I sent through his notification to let him know that he wasn't successful, he actually rang me up and you were really frustrated. And you were just like, why am I not getting these jobs? And it kind of opened up the door for me to be like, okay, this is why you're not getting the jobs, because I could see Frankie's experience was amazing. He'd done some great jobs and he actually had some really great work in his Behance portfolio, but it was just so hard to find. As a recruiter, you know, I see lots of different CVs and lots of different portfolios every single day. And I feel like to find Frankie's work, it was like digging through to find gold. And so I guess, you know, you can sort of tell the story about what happened next, Frankie.
As Karen pointed out, I was really, I just reached the end of my rope when I emailed Karen. And I just, like, I was really frustrated. And I said, I don't know why I'm getting rejected. Like, you know, I'm a great designer. I have great work and it shouldn't be this hard. And she came back and she was like, she was so nice to lend her time. She called me up. She said, if you, you know, wouldn't mind, I'd like to have a chat with you about how we could increase your portfolio presence and make it amazing. So I was all open to her suggestions because I had nothing else left. And Karen's a professional in her industry. So she had a chat and she actually told me that my Behance page was really difficult to navigate, in such that you had to click into a project, and then you had to, you know, go through the information and all the photos, then you had to click back and then go into the next project. It's really time consuming for an employer to do that when they have probably hundreds of applications to go through. So Karen said simple is best, and just to really just give them a snapshot of your work in one page format. So she said to me to do a PDF and just to showcase your work in a nice one page PDF that they can actually scroll down and tell a story through your work. So upon her knowledge and her wisdom, I went away and I fixed up my folio and came back to her with this nicely presented PDF with, you know, a bit of explanation and some photos of my projects. And it just really flowed a lot better than a Behance page did. And I think employees really responded well to that, right, Karen?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like what you had before as to what you created was chalk and cheese. And I think you sort of hit the nail on the head when I'm working with my candidates and we talk about creating a story about yourself. You know, it's not just about popping your work up on a screen. We want people to get to know you and, you know, what your journey is as a designer and, you know, what some of the amazing projects that you've worked on are and, you know, what process you had in those projects as well. And I think with your little explanations and taking on board all of my sort of suggestions to create this PDF into a beautiful flowing, you know, when you say one page, it was sort of one page to illustrate each project, I guess, in a way. And it was really clean and neat. And you really took on board everything that I had to say. And when we got that back, I was just like, this is Frankie. This is Frankie as a designer, and this sells you, and this sells your skills, and it shows your story and your journey. And it was pretty much perfect from the first second that you sent it back. And I think we did work backwards and forwards a little bit just to fine tune a few details, and then it was good to go. And I feel from there, I think pretty much the first job I put you forward for once we did have that PDF is the job that you actually did get. So it was win-win.
Yeah, it really was amazing. And with the PDF, it was maybe like 30 or 40 pages within the PDF, but you scroll down and there's just different chapters with my different roles and jobs that I've worked on over the years. But when Karen put me forth through the first job that I applied with her, that's actually my job that I have at the moment right now. So I got it, I landed it, and I was amazed that that this worked, and Karen's guidance and wisdom, and just she was amazing with helping me to develop this really amazing PDF and gave me the confidence to apply for, you know, like other jobs in the future with this knowledge of having a PDF. So I really can't thank you enough, Karen, for what you've done for me, because I will never forget it. Yeah, PDFs.
It's a very controversial topic, and I feel like everyone has their own sort of preference as to what you should and shouldn't do. But for me as a recruiter, I really feel like to give my clients what they need as quick as possible, having a PDF which tells this story and which shows work samples that are going to be relevant to the job that you are applying for is pretty much a no-brainer. Because that saves them time. It also shows them the information that they need to see, and they don't have to go searching for it. So some people do prefer to have an online presence, and for some jobs that is, yes, very relevant. But for a lot of the clients that I work with, having this PDF to tell the story has been an absolute game changer and something that I love working with candidates to help them come up with if they're not quite there with their presence on the actual sort of PDF portfolio. Because I sort of feel as a designer, you're in the day-to-day of doing your job every single day, and sometimes you just don't know how a portfolio should be presented or how to sell yourself, because you have been in the day-to-day of just working, and you possibly are the world's best designer, but you've still got to be able to showcase that to prospective employers. And I feel you did that in spades, Frankie, and it's actually been an absolute pleasure working with you on this journey and watching you evolve as well, and watching your confidence grow in your abilities and being able to sell yourself. And I do feel like, you know, when you did go for the interview for the role that you've got now, you know, they really loved you from the second that they met you, because, you know, they were really in tune with the work that you'd done, and then they met your wonderful personality, and it was all win-win from there, really.
Yeah, it went hand in hand with the work and the personality, I guess. So yeah, first impressions count. So they get a first impression from your work and then how you present yourself in the interview, but they both combine and mesh together to give you the designer.
Definitely. And I think the key to this conversation is just be open. I mean, Frankie was so open to, you know, hearing my feedback and to taking it on board. And my feedback is never a criticism. It's always constructive, because at the end of the day, if you want to get a new job, I want to be the one to help you get that new job. And I know what my clients are looking for. So if I can help draw that out of you to help you have a better chance of getting a job, then I feel like it is win-win for everyone. So having that open mind and just being really open to taking on all the feedback, I feel made this process just so seamless, from initial frustration right through to landing your dream job and, you know, being really, really happy in this current role that you're doing, which is great.
Yeah, and Karen, you really have no agendas, hey? Like, you, she really does want to help, and she really does want you to succeed, or, you know, her clients to succeed. So she was amazing, and I think we'll work together for a long time in the future, right, Karen?
I hope so. That's my plan. I'd love to continue these relationships for forever, really. And, you know, it's not just about a one-time help and pass on. It's about, you know, now following your career and, you know, understanding where you're at and just, you know, really understanding what you want to do in the future as well. And, you know, for now, everything is going so great in your role, and I'm so happy for that. And that's what I'm here for. So it's definitely not about an agenda. It's just, and I guess that's one of the values that I do love about Aquent as well. And one of the reasons that I did actually take the job to work with Aquent, because in one of my initial interviews, I was told that the whole premise behind Aquent is find people jobs they love, and then everything will flow from there. And it's so true. Like, if everyone's happy, then everything just is kind of seamless from there. So my agenda is not about forcing someone into a job or making them do something that they want to do. It's genuinely just presenting opportunities, but not all opportunities, the right opportunities to the right people. And I think, you know, when I've got someone like Frankie, who's so open to, you know, creating this amazing portfolio and putting in the work, because I would say that, you know, finding a new job is not just using your portfolio that you've had for 10 years and sending it on, because that's not going to cut it. But if you are willing to put in the work and to update your presence and to make sure that you are selling yourself in the best light, then look, I'm here to work with you and to help you with that. So big thank you to you, Frankie, and it's honestly been a massive pleasure, and I just look forward to sort of following your journey as time goes on.
And thank you, Karen, for helping me beyond my wildest dreams with, you know, getting my dream job that I have now. So yeah, thank you.
You're so welcome.